Okay guys, so today we are going to learn something amazing, I mean something interesting. We are going to learn some conditional statements and know something about looping, you know, looping, right? Okay, first of all, for today video, let me just create a variable as quick as possible. I mean, without variable it's going to be very hard to know about looping and conditional statements. I have just created a variable here, nothing else. Okay guys, as in other language, you must have known about if else statements. It's actually same in Rust. There is nothing different at all. I mean, you just have to write and just check its direction and just use the coding blocks and just write whatever you want to do here. I mean, if I want to print something, I am going to print if that something and condition, then follow that condition and something like that. Let me just print here real quick. If it's 5, then it's printing O, and else, I mean, in else, let's print wrong, maybe, I guess. Yeah, it doesn't matter actually. You can print anything you want. I'm just showing you a basic example of how you can create an if else statement in Rust language. Okay, let's create a terminal real quick. Let us build this ASAP. Okay. So what we have done here is okay, I guess I haven't saved that. Okay, now it's fine. That was actually from my previous run. I actually made some mistakes there. Okay, so it's printing ho, that means it's actually successfully running. What I have done here is I created a variable just to check my if statement and nothing else. If n is equal to 5, that this block is going to be executed. If n is not equal to 5, then this block is going to be executed. If I want to create something like nested if else statement here, what I am going to do is using else if here, else if, and let's place it as 6. Print, let's print 6 here. Else let's print no, maybe. Yeah, let's print no. Let's remove this 5 here and change it to 6, and we are done guys. Let's quickly run it. Okay guys, so what I have actually done is I have created a variable which is holding the value 6. What is actually happening is that my compiler read this line, if n equal to 5, print ho. What it understand that n is not equal to 5, that's why it go to another line, that means this else if statement, and it check there whether n is equal to 5 or 6. If it is 6, which is it, it's printed 6 as it is, then it won't need to read else statement, right? I mean, it actually terminated here. So these are the basic conditional statements guys. Let's go to looping now. I really want to discuss that topic in this video because I haven't been able to post video lately. Okay guys, so yeah, there is one more thing that I haven't taught you right about, that's mutable values. What actually mutable values are, what MUT is actually, whenever I declare a variable here n equal to 6, what I am actually doing is letting the n store the value 6, nothing else. But what if I want to use statement like this, n equal to n plus 1 or something like that, any operation with n? Actually I can't use this statement because n is just holding the value 6, it can't do anything else. If I want to do some operations with n, what I need to do is mute this value. First of all, I need to mute the value of n. As soon as mute the value of n, I can now operate with n further. I mean, I can change its value further now. So if I, whenever I want to mute, I mean, I want to reuse my variable again and again somewhere or some operations with it, then what I need to do is mute my value first. So guys, don't forget this mute. I mean, it's a very small word, and yeah, that's all. So guys, in Rust there are actually several kinds of loop. I mean, while do, while for, and there is actually a loop named as loop. What you need to do if you want to create a loop, what you need to do is just use the keyword loop here and just create your block coding blocks here, and whatever you are going to print here, it's going to go infinitely because I haven't set any break statement. That's basically our loop is. Okay, so let's print something here. Let's print our value n here. I mean, why not? Okay, so I am printing my value n here. If I execute this program now, what's actually going to happen is 6 is going to be printed infinitely time and my compiler is going to get broken. So let's not do this. Let's give the n value of 0 and let's create a breakpoint for it. I mean, a loop must break at some point, right? For that, what I am going to do is, if I am just creating a statement so that I can set when it's going to break actually. If n is equals to let's break it at 10. Okay, I can't break this here. Let's just break it. Now what's actually happening is, as soon as my n is equals to 10, it's actually going to break this loop. This loop will get broken. For this to actually work, what I need to do is increase my value of n. Okay, so what's actually happening is n is now increasing, and as soon as n reaches 10, it's going to break the loop. Let's see how this work. I mean, see, as you can see here, the loop has been successfully executed. It's printing the value 10 again and again. I have created a mutable variable, and because I want to do some operations here. If I haven't used my mutable value here, but I want to show you guys what actually happens and why I love this very much. See, there it's clearly written that first assignment to n, make this binding mutable. It's actually saying me to create this binding mutable. I mean, it's that good. In other languages, it's just going to directly throw you an error, but in Rust, it's actually saying that you need to mute this variable. It's giving you hint, you just have to mute it. Okay, that's one of the point why I like Rust so much. I mean, it's very nice that now not only you can know where you are doing wrong, but you're actually getting hints how you can correct it. Okay guys, so these are the normal loops. It's like for loop, right? I mean, you are just creating this, and I mean, there is no something like for loop here. I mean, there is no keyword for any particular loops. You can create some do while loops here too. I mean, if you want to create some while loop, what you need to do is just while. Now what I'm going to do here is put my statement here, n equal to 20, I guess. And now my while condition block. Let's print value of n. Okay, I am printing n here. Let's print our n here. Let's increase our value of n. That's all, I guess. Yeah, I think this is going to throw an error. I don't really know. There is something that I have been confused with Rust so far. Let's see. Yeah, it's actually throwing error because it won't able to understand this. I don't really know why this is happening, but I have been facing this problem a lot. If you guys know, then tell me. Okay guys, so now it's going to work. Okay. I did a mistake there. I actually used n is equals to. I just need to write n is not equals to. That was the biggest mistake of mine. I want to print something, right? Okay, now it's fine. While n is not equal to 20, what it's going to do is actually print this whole statement again and again. These are our while loops in Rust language. So guys, these that's for loops, right? I mean, we have seen it today how you can create if-else statements and how you can work with loops in Rust language. That's for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you guys like and enjoy our video.